Hello, and welcome back to my time zone converter video series. Today, this is part 3, and I'll be talking about how we use CDS to get the list of time zones. I've already covered in part 1 how to build the flow that actually does the conversion, and in part 2, I talked about actually building the app in PowerApps. I haven't finished the app yet, but I started it. Our objectives are, for this series, to build an app that uses Flow's convert time zone action, that was covered in part 1, to use PowerApps to collect the date and time, the source time zone, and the destination time zone. I started that in part 2. Today I'll be talking about using the Common Data Service, or CDS, to get a list of time zones. And then finally, I'll talk about connecting Flow and CDS to PowerApps and actually performing the conversion. So just as a reminder, this is what the finished app looks like. I will resume building it in a minute, but I just wanted to show you kind of where we're headed. The goal here is to be able to pick the date, the time, to pick the source time zone from a list here, and then once I pick my source time zone, to then pick a destination time zone, and then click convert, and have it convert. And I'll be using CDS, or Common Data Service, to get one list, really, to populate these two dropdowns. So this is part 3, getting the time zones from CDS. So I'm going to be using one of the time zone entities that comes built into Common Data Service. I'm going to be using the time zone definitions. The time zone definitions have several attributes. So the only two you need to worry about are standard name and user interface name. Standard name is the time zone name for the standard time, and the user interface name is the display name for the time zone in the Microsoft Windows registry. And I'll show you what it looks like in a second. So here we are back in the app that we started in the previous video. And today I'm going to go ahead and start by creating a new screen. And you can go up here to insert new screen. I'm just going to do a blank screen. And I'm going to go ahead and add a gallery. You can do a couple different kinds of galleries. I just go ahead and do blank. Some people will say you should always go with one like that. Well, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and do one that has a sample data source. It'll be easier to see the change. I am going to change this, though, to just title and subtitle. There's going to be no images involved for this. Okay. This is going to be my time zone definition. I'm just going to do defs gallery. Actually, no. Break my own rules. Definitions gallery. Time zone definitions gallery. But I need to get the data source. To do that, I'm going to add a data source. And I'm going to go ahead and do common data source. And I'm going to search for time zones. And there it is, time zone definitions. Connect. So remember standard name, and then you have user interface name. As I said, those two are the only two that really matter. And let's go ahead and adjust this a little bit. We can give this a new name. This could be user interface. Sorry, user interface name. And this one is going to be standard name. Okay, far so good. I hit play, I can scroll through, and you can see a lot of the time zones are there. We're not going to be using this gallery, by the way. This is just so I can show you what the time zones look like. You don't have to actually build this when you're building your app. This is purely just to sort of explain and show you what the time zone data looks like. To look at the data further, I'm going to go ahead and add a display form. And for this one, it's also going to be time zone definitions. And This one you can add a few more fields, but let's go ahead and start with standard name, user interface name. We'll do time zone code. I don't know what daylight name is. Maybe bias. Maybe the definition. You can do created by, created on, modified by, modified on. That sounds about right. Alright. And then we just need to adjust this. Like so. And then I need to change the item to be like that. I'll give this a name, time zone definition viewer. I can do one like that. If I play it, so it looks like bias and daylight name don't have anything, and created by and modified by don't have anything. Well, let me try different. Yeah, those don't seem to have anything, so I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of those. They're taking up space. So far, so good. So, again, this is just to sort of show you what the data looks like. And now we can go back to screen one, now that we've established a data connection. And you can always view your data sources by coming up to View and click Data Sources, and you'll see all your data sources here. You can also remove data sources if you have any extraneous data sources. Sometimes as you're building an app, you'll add data sources, and later on you'll realize that you don't need that data source, so you'll remove it. So it's always good to clean up your data sources before you publish an app. You don't need extra connections weighing down your app's resources. Come in here, and what I need to do now is I need to change these two dropdowns to actually look for that data that we just created. So I'm going to go hit it here, and do time zone definitions, and here, time zone definitions. Now we're not quite done yet, but let's just take a quick look. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Looking good. Now, both of these have, by default, let's see if I go to advanced. Yeah, they have select multiple true. I want to make that false. We don't need to select multiple time zones. You'll notice I have them both selected. It says multiple controls. This allows me to change when I have common values that I want to change. I can select multiples like that. And then this particular combo box, you can change the way the data is displayed. So I can make it a double, and I can change this to, let's say I want to do user interface and I want to do standard name. Now if I do that, now I get both as opposed to just one. So I can do that here. Standard, user interface, or you could do user interface and standard. Functionally, it makes no difference. It's just dealer's preference, I guess. Now, this is just a little bit nitpicking. It says find items. I don't particularly like that, so I always like to change that. I'd like to be very specific as possible, so it's like source time zone. And then select destination. You can see if I try to search for Arabic, it doesn't show up. But if I search for Baghdad, it shows up. That's a potential problem that you can solve. Where it says search user fields here, what you can do is you can copy your display fields and just paste that over here. Now, if I come here and I do Arabic, there it is. Like so. And to get rid of one, just like that. So we've got the CDS connected. Looking good. All right, so that's how you get CDS connected to your app. In my next video, I'll be finishing it up by connecting everything together, the flow and CDS and the Power Apps. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe. If you'd like to know more, you can reach out to me on Twitter at @JWillisRose. I'm also on LinkedIn. You can find me on the community forum. And also just leave comments below. I look forward to hearing from you guys. Feedback is welcome. Thank you.